The first thing you're going to want to do in GarageBand is start a new file, and then make sure you're in the Live Loop section, and then select one of the loop packs to start with. For today, we're going to use the R&B loop pack to create our ringtone. Now, I'm going to sample out different sounds to see if I like them. Yeah, not really a fan of this particular collection of sounds for my ringtone, so I'm going to speed through this process till I get to something that I like. Then once I've settled on that, I'm going to record it using the red circle at the top of the screen. Once I've recorded my audio, I'm then going to clean it up a little bit, but this step is actually a little unnecessary, hence why I'm speeding through it. That'll make a little bit more sense as we get towards the end of the video. Once we've done that, we're going to go back to the start screen and then rename our new ringtone. Now for this, I'm going to use something very, very creative, and that is ringtone 003. So creative. Once I've renamed my ringtone, I'm then going to share it, and the option I want to select is ringtone right in the middle. Now, the ringtone length needs to be adjusted. It needs to be 30 seconds or less. And this is the step I mentioned earlier. If you press continue, it's going to automatically adjust the length. So what I did earlier wasn't necessary. You can look at the options that they give you here. There's not really anything you need to do here. So simply press export in the upper right hand corner. And then allow the iPad to do what it does, or iPhone. How long this takes depends on your device. Then you'll select Use Sound As. You can select Standard Ringtone, Standard Text Tone, or you can assign your new ringtone to a specific contact, whether it be mom, dad, your puppy, your kitten, whoever you want. Or you select Done and it won't assign to anybody. And that's it, you're finished. Now, if you're wondering where your ringtone is, you can go to Settings, search Ringtone under Sounds, and try it out to see if it's there. And that's it, folks, you're done. Now, if that was a little bit too fast for you, if you have any further questions, feel free to put that in the comments below, and please like and subscribe if you love this content and want to see more like it, or if there's something else in GarageBand you'd like to learn that you didn't see here. Take care, and I'll talk to you next time. Peace.